Verse 15. Wherefore I also, after I've heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love for all the saints, cease not to give thanks for you, making mention of you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. We'll have to really think something around there. Let's do that verse 17 again together tonight. Now, this man of God, Paul, is praying for the saints. This is a prayer. He is praying for them. Now, this is the prayer. That the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you the spirit. Not the information, but the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. Let's do that together again. That the God of our Lord Jesus, the Father of glory, may give you or me the spirit of wisdom and the revelation in the knowledge of him. I think we must underline something there, that your revelation about him is your limitation. You will never move with him beyond your level of revelation. Now, let me say this way. He can't give it to you more than your revelation is your limitation. Yeah. With God, you can go with God as far as your revelation. So he's praying for them here and saying, you need to have a revelation in the knowledge of him. Not only to be taught about him, but him to be revealed in you. You must have what we call revelation knowledge. When you begin to know things about God in God without being told. Give me an amen, please.
Amen.
Support me here. I want to sit down. You have to know things in God. You must come to a level where you know things by it. When things are revealed and you know them without a lecturer, without a pastor, without, these things must be revealed in you. What I'm saying, man of God, I'm saying, when Peter said to Jesus, let's build houses at the mountain, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elias. No one told him that was Moses. No one told him. He knew by revelation. It had to be revealed. Hallelujah. So we say tonight, our revelation of him is our limitation. The boundary in the things of God is the way you understand him. The more you know more about him, is the more you get more stuff from him.
Let me say it again.
The more you will have more revelation. That's why our senior season must be a time where we download revelation. No time to play games in the pulpit. We download. So when we get more, we get more stuff. Oh, how can I say that? How can I say that? When we know more about him, we can get more from him. When we know more of him, you set the theme here to be identified with him.
Yeah.
Oh, once you know that, you are seated with him in the heavenly places. Once you know that you were killed with him, you were buried with him, and you were raised with him, and you ascended up together with him. While I'm here, I am seated positionally. Positionally, I'm not here. My body is here. Yes, I am here. But my spirit is somewhere else. I operate from another dimension.
Okay.
Hallelujah.
You have to know that. Now we're praying for them that this must be what? Revealed. Come on, say revealed. Let me say it this way. No one can teach you God. He must be revealed. Oh, Jesus said one day, who to say people are the Son of Man is? And they say like John the Baptist, and all they were wrong. And later Peter said, you are the Christ, the Son of God. Just no. This thing was not given to you by man. It was revealed by my Father. You can only know him by revelation, not by information. This is not math or science or whatever you are doing here. This is not law. These are things of the Spirit. So they are what? They are revealed.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, better. So these things are what? Are revealed. Remember one day when Joseph, oh my Lord, when Joseph was in charge in Egypt and his family came to buy food. The Bible says Joseph saw his brothers and they couldn't see or see him. And then they came again for the second trip after 7 years to buy again. And the Bible says Joseph decided to reveal himself to them. Let me say to you, God has been seeing you, looking after you, passing you, making, but tonight he may decide to reveal himself to you. He is known by revelation, not information. That's why we don't teach unbelievers. We teach the child of God. We teach those who have been revealed to them.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Moving up and down. It's not our style. Amen. You turn your edge of it. That's what you do. I know you are good people. Let's go to verse 18 before I get excited. That your eyes of your understanding may be enlightened. We are people of God. When we fail in the natural, it's not over with us. We must step in another power. Let your eyes of your understanding be enlightened. Oh my God. When you are failing in the natural, it is not over with you. The devil is a liar. When I can't figure out my way using my senses, I will use my faith. Oh my God. If I can't make it in the natural, I've got an advantage, what we call the believer advantage. As a child of God, you have what we call believer advantage. You can achieve more than the unbelievers.
Amen.
What greater is he? Let's do this again. Now, your eye, the eyes of your understanding must be enlightened. Now, to what? So that you may know, oh my Lord, the hope of the calling. This calling is called hope. What is the hope of the calling? Is that he will not take you out and not bring you in. Oh, the calling has got hope. And what is hope? I won't take you out of Egypt and not give you the promised land. Whenever I take you out, I will always put you in, because the hope is in the calling. You must know, because you are with him, you are in him. In this book, there's too much about in him, in him, in him. Now, that in him, the writer there is thinking of Adam in the garden. Now, he's saying, if a man is in Christ, like Adam in the garden. God created the garden first and put Adam in the garden as prepared. God prepared Jesus and put you in Him. So we are in Him. Our provision is in Him. Our healing is in Him. Oh my God. Our way out is in Him. We are identified with Him. Hallelujah. Identified with Him. Now we know that there is hope in the calling. Amen. Or this calling has got what? Hope. Come on, let's talk. This calling has got what?
Hope.
Let me tell Long Dollar. But I don't know, your God dying before his one gila. He will never call you out. And then leave you on the streets. When he calls out, he puts in. There is hope in the calling. But number three, my points as I close. Number three, he says not only that you will know the hope, but you must also know the riches of his glorious inheritance in the saints. Oh, but the one you must know in the heart of heart that in God you have the inheritance that no one can take it away. When they say there's darkness in Egypt, you must say there's light in Goshen. I have inheritance with God. When they say things are bad, I say sorry. Where I am, there's light. When they say things are not there, there's scarcity around here. I don't see that. I see abundance. Why? Because I have my staff, and my staff has my name on it. You can take them away from me. Lord Jesus, you must know the inheritance. The message of redemption is not finished if you don't add the inheritance. He redeemed us to give us Eva. You have what? The inheritance. You have what?
The inheritance.
You must know that. If you are now being identified with Him, identified in Him, you must know that you have the inheritance. And no one can take it away. According to Galatians 4, I don't have time. He says, as long as the heir is still a child, he differs not from the slave, even though he's the owner of the whole estate. You must grow up to possess your inheritance. Time to be paid in the Lord. Those days are over. You have to grow up and take over what belongs to you. Too long. As long as you are the baby, you are seen like servants. You beg what belongs to you. But when Shalifa, you have too long, then Shalifa will possess. It's my new English, then Shalifa. Then Shalifa. You have to possess your possession. Remember the 12 spies. The 10 guys were babies with beard. They said, we can't take it. The giants are too big. were like grasshoppers, and so we were on their side. But the two ones, the matured ones, they said, no, 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 our God is able. My mother, not only God is able, but we are also well able. We will take over the land. Once you grow up, you can possess. You can take over. Aziphele izingane kaJesu, ungabi ingane yakaJesu, amen. Njalo uyolandwa, wathunyelwa ikhansela yokulanda, sewudubile. Kwiresi yakho sokunika umkhuleko, asakuboni ke-CF. Those days are over. The days of being easily offended. The days of argument, man, and say, hey, baby, kuluma ngam, let's kulume ngobani. Come on, man, serious, let's kulume ngobani. Let me tell you, if you still argue that, you're still a baby. The unbelievers, okay, manage. The celebrities that they love so much, they have their names written on newspapers or TV, whatever. But they still face life with a charm.
Yeah.
Think about that. They have courage. Because you will never possess, you will never possess your land unless you have what? Courage. Let me show you and sit down. God took them with a longer route. Isn't that, huh? With a longer route. And there was a short route. And there was a short. You must know that. Don't always say how job really doctor. You can't be shame. How we are need to smart. It's not in the word of God. Don't wait on the Lord. That's prophetic utterance. I'll tell you next time what is that. Now listen to me. There was a short route of 11 days to possess the promised land. But they go the route that takes too long. How many years?
4 years.
Why? The Bible says God feared that they are still weak. After these 400 years in exile, they are weak when they face the enemy in this short route.
Oh my Lord, oh my God.
The short route had got some enemies. Then God said, no man, my people will lose heart. Let me take them the long route. Why? Because they are cowards. They don't have courage. Let's go to chapter 1 of Joshua. God said, Joshua, be of courage and be of cool courage and rise up and take them to the land. You will never get your possession unless you are a man or a lady of courage. It's not the word of cowards. Courage. Courage. Face your fears. You know you want to do, change the course and do something great and something wonderful, but you lack courage. You will never possess your land.
Masan Kuruma Dami Niti Ute Mkize, there is a short route.
There is a, but it demands what?
Courage.
A lot of people. Long journey. There is a short journey to your promised land, but there must be courage. Not because you are a better student, but because you have courage to face your fears, because you know
that you are now together with him. As I close on this teaching, and close with this, that will help us, then we're going to pray. There was a man called Melchizedek. He was a king of Salem. And no one knows his genealogy, where he come from and where he was going. And he met Abraham. And Abraham was from the battle, with the spoils of the battle, with the stuff, with everything. And Abraham, catch this, Abraham gave Melchizedek, the king of Salem, the 10% of what he got in the battlefield. And Melchizedek blessed him. And they had a communion on that, the bread and the wine. Oh my Lord. Oh. Let's not go there. Then God called the fourth generation of Abraham, which is called Levi or Levites. He called them to stop working and live in the temple. Then he said, let men, oh Lord, pay tithes or give tithes to the Levites. Then he said, I'm closing, then he said, the Levites or Levi, who is now collecting tithes from my people, he wants pay tithes. And they said, when did he pay tithes? They said, he was in his loins, right? Of his grandfather Abraham. When Abraham was giving tithes, he was giving with Levi, who is not even his son, who is the fourth generation. Oh, I'm saying what? I'm saying Levi was identified with Abraham. When Abraham was doing good, Levi was with Abraham. Oh my Lord. When we say we are now identified with him, we simply say we were in him.
Yes.
I will never be born. We were in him. When they crucified him. Oh, when they mock him. Oh, when they lead him. Oh, my God. You were in him. Oh, when they laid him on that pole between heaven and earth. As if he was not in heaven and even not in earth. Just in his place there, you were with him. When they say, if you're a son of God, deliver us and yourself, he was there with you. You were in him. Oh my God, when they pissed on his side and killed him, and he died and said, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani, my God, why have thou forsaken me? You were there, you were in him. You are now identified with him. Oh, when they put him in the tomb, when he rose on the dead day, come on, brother, help me. When he rose there, you were there with him. Identity. Identified with him. Let's say, what fears him should fear you. It's a problem.
Amen.
The things that were running away when he shows up, they have to run away when he shows up. You can't be a powerless Christian. And just think who on Christ is just to come here and have a good time. It's not that we are chill, just chill. Now we don't chill, like I said, we don't chill here. We came here to be empowered and face the world. So that easy fancy men wako and they summer here and summer when. No, I won't swag. And man, and as I close, if you are in him, if you are in him, and we are cool tonight, this tonight, you are not. You are not the sick trying to be healed. You are the healed one, and you must defend your healing.
Yes.
Let me say it to you, because I'm gonna pray. You know, whatever is your challenge, you are not the sick one that is trying to be healed. with grandpa, with whatever you are drinking, trying to be healed. No, no, no. You must know your position. You are the healed one. You have to defend what is yours. Because the enemy only comes to steal. Someone is trying to steal your health. But you can defend it. Defend your territory. Defend your possessions. Because you are now identified with him. You're gonna pray just now. I'm posing you a challenge. The things that are scared for him, they must be terrified when they show up. Poverty, lack, and scarcity, and trying to get by is not our portion. I like it as a country shaz, a toilet up there. Country shaz, we have to go on a banana pants. Pants. I'm closing by saying the things that are scared of him are scared of you. That's all standing.